In the more than 18 years I've been driving luxury cars for executive class, viewers often ask, what's the best one? Or what's my favorite? Well, the safe answer is, it depends. Though it's true, everything depends on what you intend to use it for, and of course, how much you're willing to spend. Secretly in my mind, however, I often think of at least one car model, the Porsche Cayenne. I've felt that way since I first drove the updated first-generation Cayenne in Spain back in 2007, and then again during the second-generation models launch in Germany in 2010. Through the next two decades, I've watched the Cayenne rack up wins and records on and off the track, not to mention sales records for Porsche dealers worldwide. But it's been a while since I last drove a Cayenne, and I was wondering, I'd still feel the same way about Porsche's best-selling model as I did back then. Lucky for me, I got a chance to try their latest one while visiting the hometown of Porsche last autumn. Right, so we're leaving Stuttgart, the city center, and we are entering some really pretty landscape. I hear a lot of vineyards around here. So this is gonna be a hilly area we're gonna be passing through. And the sun is out, so perfect day to drive. On this drive through the surrounding villages and vineyards of Stuttgart, Porsche lent me the latest generation 2024 Cayenne S with a V8 petrol engine that could be among the last of its kind before Porsche rolls out fully electric powertrains. On my first day with a new Cayenne, I decided on a leisurely drive across a scenic countryside. Nothing on the route to push the Cayenne to its upper limits of speed, horsepower, and off-road abilities. But still a great way to familiarize myself with the changes made to the new generation model. Okay, here we go. Up the hills. We're entering wine country. Let's admit it. Even if this SUV can handle the most challenging conditions, most owners don't really push their Cayenne to extremes anyway. Still, I wanted to find out if the car is just as easy and enjoyable to drive and comfortable as I recall it to be. Basically, it just feels right. If it fits most Cayenne owners' lifestyles, like, who knows, those who own a winery, or if it looks just as stunning from the inside and out. Ah, oh, this is beautiful. No doubt, it does. This car is even more beautiful than previous editions, more so amidst the autumn foliage of what's fondly called the Tuscany of Germany. Indeed, so beautiful, the Cayenne fits in perfectly with this vine-covered terraced landscape overlooking the Neckar Valley. Back behind the wheel and looking out the window, I recognize grape varieties grown here and realize the wines produced on these slopes are among the most expensive in Germany. So yes, I guess the Cayenne fits right in. So classy. And practical too. In fact, I've seen a number of Cayennes pass me on these roads, which makes a lot of sense. During heavy rain or snow in these parts, only a car with the power, height, and off-road abilities could get you as quickly and safely through the slippery and muddy hilly terrain. But lucky for me, I won't have to find out for myself because the weather today is perfect. But even then, the Cayenne gives you the confidence to drive anywhere the road takes you, even off-road if you want to see the most lovely landscapes of Germany. Okay, just one last stop before we return to the city. It's to catch this beautiful scenery. So, Robert Frost was right. Take a road less traveled, and it makes all the difference. Of course, if you plan to take the road less traveled, make sure you give it a car capable of taking that road. It's day two with the Cayenne, and this time I've decided to push the car a bit harder to get a better sense of the improvements made to the chassis and suspension system. This route I'm taking will test the Cayenne's power and control on the autobahn, where entire stretches of the wide-open motorway have no speed limit. The slippery roads and low visibility caused by the heavy downpour make the drive even more challenging. But this is exactly what the Cayenne was built for. After getting off the autobahn, I'm headed towards the nature reserves and mountains on the rim of the Black Forest, where some of the region's most picturesque villages are found. Again, rainy conditions, not the best for filming a test drive like what we're doing, but personally, it just makes everything so romantic. The mist, the fog, reflections on the road. Yeah, this is quite an experience. The hairpin curve coming up. So far, so good. The Cayenne's showing stability and control when you need it most. It's got the power when you need it. It's got all the safety features for slippery country roads like this and mountain passes. Best of all, it's the chassis for me. I just love the chassis technology of the Cayenne. Always so comfortable. No rolls. Yep, no rolling around on your seat. The new and improved chassis design was built from scratch to combine a sporty performance with a comfortable ride. The drive is, well, even more stable and so much sportier now. If not for the ride height, you'd think you were behind a wheel of the lower profile Porsche Panameras, or at times, the 911s. Not sure if you can hear that. It's the sound of the engine roar, the V8 power plant inside his car. Now, when the Cayenne finally migrates to full electric, you kind of miss that sound. But I don't think you're going to miss the way this car drives, because that's something that Porsche will never let go of. The driving dynamics. In this latest model, Porsche improves the existing dynamic chassis control technology and introduces new active systems such as rear axle steering, electromechanical rolling motion compensation, and adaptive three-chamber air suspension to create better response and control. Last thing you want to worry about is safety. Can the car climb the mountain? Will the brakes work? Will you be nauseous driving through all these twists and turns? Not at all. The Cayenne is built for roads like this, so you can just enjoy the journey and not worry about the car. In other words, Porsche does the hard work, so you can focus instead on enjoying the drive and the scenery in front of you. So this is just a small part of Germany. But multiply this scenery, multiply this road network all throughout this huge country, and you get an idea why it's so fun to drive in Germany and why people just love their cars in Germany. I'm sure even a tiny Volkswagen would get you this deep into forest terrain. German roads are that good. But few would get you to this point as effortlessly and comfortably as the Cayenne could. Oh, look at this. This is why you need a car like the Cayenne, to get you to places as distant and as isolated as where we are right now. And that's what I love about this car. It's a car that allows you to just go anywhere and do anything. Too bad I only had a couple of days enjoying the Cayenne in the Autobahn and on the country roads of Germany, because a car as exhilarating as this deserves to be driven more often, especially if you want to test its capabilities. Well, good thing Porsche in the Philippines lent me their latest model to drive around our own streets. Well, from from the inside and from the outside and pretty much any angle, the e-hybrid Cayenne looks like the standard Cayenne model with a combustion engine. The only difference would be the, well, noticeable difference that is, would be the neon green hybrid badge and brake calipers. Really cool. Well, that of course, and the consumption and emission numbers. It's a hybrid after all. The Cayenne e-hybrid comes with a 3-liter V6 turbocharged engine, which works in combination with two 130 kilowatt electric motors, one on each axle, both powered by an onboard rechargeable battery. The Cayenne e-hybrid uses what's called plug-in hybrid technology. It's pretty much the closest a hybrid vehicle can get to becoming a fully electric vehicle. Although the range of a plug-in hybrid is limited compared to a full EV like, say, the Audi e-tron, it's still quite capable. In fact, with the e-hybrid Cayenne, you can go up to 80 kilometers without ever having to use a gas engine. In the real world, switching to e-power exclusively provides more than enough range to get me from Makati to Ayala Greenfield Estates at the foot of Mount Makiling overlooking Laguna de Bay. Though drivers have a choice to engage the hybrid mode where the gas engine and electric motors work in tandem, and when the batteries have no charge left, one of two sport modes using the petrol engine can also be engaged. Surprisingly, the driving dynamics is consistent across all drive modes, so there's no substantial compromise in power and feel. Isn't that cool? Owners of the Cayenne model with a combustion engine will find the driving dynamics and the overall driving experience of the e-hybrid very familiar. They share the same chassis and suspension system, after all. Yes, it's the same chassis I raved about in the Cayenne S I drove around Germany, with all the new features that make the drive so sporty yet comfortable simultaneously. The new and improved technology like adaptive 3-chamber air suspension, electromechanical roll stabilization, and 4D chassis control are more than fancy terms. They provide real-world results when cornering and on uneven road surfaces, especially on off-road terrain. You get that across all Cayenne models, including the new e-hybrid version. The only noticeable difference, however, is with the power, especially when the electric motors and the V6 turbo engine combine. And boy, is it obvious. It accelerates like a rocket, on straights, then on corners, even when driving this heavy chunk of metal uphill. Electrified or not, it's got Porsche DNA all over it. A sports car on stilts, without a roll and lean of tall SUVs. The Cayenne, in my opinion, and any Cayenne, has always been the best SUV on the market. In my opinion, at least. Apart from its superior chassis and suspension system, the Cayenne ticks all the boxes that make it the ultimate SUV. No, the ultimate car. Let's go through each. Cabin space? Check. Height? Check again. What about safety? Porsche includes a new LED light system that adapts to various environments, plus an array of driver assistance features to avoid accidents. So, check. And comfort? Check. Apart from the supple leather seats, ambient lighting, and luxurious cabin amenities, it's a chassis technology to improve stability and control that's most impressive. Sports performance is a big check as well, with exhilarating sport drive modes available. Off-road performance is another big check. Cayenne may look elegant and beautiful, but it was built to handle rocks, mud, waist-deep water, ice, and snow as well. Of course, all that's expected by now from any Cayenne model. The best surprise from the e-hybrid is its low carbon emissions and gas consumption. A whopping 55 kilometers per liter on auto hybrid mode, according to Porsche. Zero consumption and emissions on e-power alone. But whether it's equipped with a petrol engine or plug-in technology, whether it's driving through the vineyards of the Neckar Valley, or on the hills of Ayala Greenfields. There's no doubt in my mind today, as it was a decade earlier. the Porsche Cayenne is as close as it gets, achieving the ultimate driving experience. And that's all for this episode of Executive Class. I'm David Celdran. Thanks for watching.